Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum dear students. Hope you are well. I'm your English teacher from my UAS school and I'm conducting class 9. So follow my instructions carefully. You should have your second stage English book run for class 9 and hold a pencil. You have to be attentive during the class. And during the class, I'll share a screen with you. And you have to take the screenshot. Then at the end of the class, you have to complete all the work in your fair copy. So today's topic of unit number 7 is life skills. That is present in your English book. And in exercise 7.3, there is a language practice and the topic name is translation. So very first, we have to take the review of the tenses. In this slide, we have the four tenses about the present simple, present continuous, present perfect, and the present perfect continuous tense. So we talk about the affirmative, or we can say the positive sentences. I prefer my coffee black. So this sentence is followed by the structure of present simple, because I we are using here as a subject. Prefer is the first form of the verb, and the remaining part of the sentence we are considering as an object. So I prefer my coffee black, that is the sentence of, or that is the example of present simple tense. Now let's see the example of negative sentence of present simple tense. I do not prefer my coffee black. It means simply we have to put do not after the subject, then first form of the verb, and then object. So I do not prefer my coffee black. That is the example of negative sentence of present simple tense. While if we see the example of interrogative sentence, simply we have to use the helping verb at the start of a sentence, then we use the subject, then the first form of the verb, and then object. And at the end of the sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation, that is very compulsory just to make the interrogative sentences. This is all about the examples of present simple, positive, or we can say the affirmative, negative, or the interrogative sentences. Now we talk about the examples of present continuous tense. So very first, we have to take the review of the structure. Very first, we have to use the subject, then helping verb. We have the three helping verb here in the affirmative, negative, or in the interrogative, is am and are. Then the first form of the verb with ing, and then object. So she is listening the music now, which means she is a subject we are using here, is a helping verb, and listening is the first form of the verb with ing, and then the object. This is the example of affirmative sentence of present continuous tense. Now let's see the negative example of present continuous tense. Very first, we have to use the subject, then simply we have to use not after the helping verb. As I already told you a little while ago that we have three helping verbs, is, am, and are. Now the first form of the verb with ing and then the object. So she is not listening the music now. That is the example of negative sentence of present continuous tense. Now see the example of interrogative sentence of present continuous. Is she listening the music now? It means simply we have to use the helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, and then the first form of the verb with ing, and then object. And at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. Now in the present perfect tense, in the affirmative sentence, we have to use the subject at the start of a sentence. Then we have the two helping verb, has or have. We can use has with the singular and we can use with have. And then we have to use the third form of the verb. And then a lot lately is the object. So it has rained a lot lately. It means this sentence or this example is totally followed the structure of present perfect tense. Now let's see the example of negative sentence. It has not rained a lot lately. It means simply we use not after the helping verb has, because has we are using here as a helping verb. So it has not rained a lot lately. This is the negative example of present perfect tense. Now if we want to talk about the interrogative sentences, so has it rained a lot lately, which means we use the helping verb at the start of a sentence, then we use subject, then third form of the verb, and then the object. And at the end of a sentence, continue, I'm going to tell you that the sign of interrogation is very compulsory because we are making the interrogative sentences. So this is all about the examples of affirmative, negative, and interrogative sentences of present perfect tense. Now we talk about the present perfect continuous tense. In the affirmative or the positive sentences, the example we have, she has been singing a song for 5 minutes. It means we have to helping verb has been or have been. So we are here using the helping verb has been. She has been singing. We have, again, we have to use the ing form and then object. She has been singing a song for 5 minutes. This is the example of affirmative sentence of present perfect continuous tense. While in the negative example, we have she has not been singing a song for 5 minutes. As you are saying in the slide, that we have a two helping verb has or been. And if you want to change the same sentence into the negative, then simply we have to use not between has or been. Okay, so she has not been singing a song for 5 minutes. This is the example of negative sentence of present perfect continuous tense. Now, let's see the example of interrogative sentence. As I already told you that we have two helping verb in this tense, present perfect continuous tense. So one helping verb we can use at the start of a sentence, and the another helping verb we can use after the subject. So we can write the sentence like that. Has she been singing a song for 5 minutes? Again, at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. So please take a screenshot. So it will be very helpful for you for understanding the tenses of present simple, present continuous, present perfect, and the present perfect continuous. Hopefully you got the screenshot. Now let's see the examples of past simple, past continuous, past perfect, and the past perfect continuous tense. If we talk about the affirmative or the positive sentences, we have example, we watched the news last night. We watched the news last night. It means we are using the subject at the start of a sentence. Then we use the second form of the verb. Then the news last night, it means we are using the object at the end. I mean, after the verb, we have to use the object. This is the structure. This is the example of past simple affirmative sentences. While we talk about the negative sentences, so we have a helping verb did here. And if we use the did in the sentence while we want to make the sentence of negative or the interrogative, so simply the second form of the verb will be changed into the first form. For example, we have a positive sentence or the affirmative sentence that we watched the news last night. It means we are using the second form of the verb. But in the negative sentence, if we are using did in the sentence, I mean did not, so we have to use the first form of the verb. So we have to write the sentence like that. We did not watch the news last night. Is it clear, my dear students? Now look at the examples of interrogative sentence of past simple. Very first, we have to use did, the helping verb at the start of a sentence. Then we use the subject, then the first form of the verb, and then the object. Did we watch the news last night? And at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. Now, this is all the examples of past simple, affirmative, negative, or interrogative sentences. Now, let's see the example of past continuous tense. Very first, we have to take the review of the structure. Subject, then helping verb. We have the two helping verb, was and were, and then the first form of the verb with ing, then object. So, the example we have, I was learning German last year. This is the example of past continuous tense. In the negative sentence, we have example, I was not learning German last year. It means we are just using not after this helping verb. I was not learning German last year. While in the interrogative sentences, was I learning German last year? It means we use helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, then the first form of the verb with ing, and then object. And again, at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. Is it clear? This is all about the examples of past continuous tense. Now, see the examples of past perfect affirmative sentence. He had left when I went to the club. We have to use the subject, then had, because we have a helping verb had, and left is a third form of the verb, because that is a structure of past perfect tense, then the subject, then the helping verb had, and the third form of the verb. So we have the example, he had left when I went to the club. Now, see the example of negative sentence of past perfect. He had not left when I went to the club. Which means simply we use not after the helping verb, because as I already told you that we have a helping verb had, and if you want to change the same sentence into the negative, so simply we have to use not after the subject. He had not left when I went to the club. So, in the interrogative sentences, we have the example of past perfect tense, had he left when I went to the club, means we are using helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, and then the third form of the verb. And at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. All right. Now, let's see the example of past perfect continuous tense. In the past perfect continuous tense, we use subject, then had been, then the first form of the verb with ing, and then object. They had been being friends since childhood. That is the example of affirmative sentence of past perfect continuous tense. While in the negative, they had not been being friends since childhood. That is the negative sentence of past perfect tense. As I already told you that if we have a two helping verb in a one tense, then simply we use not. If we are making the negative sentence, simply we use not between the helping verb. So had been is a helping verb, so we have to use not between had or been. So they had not been being friends since childhood. Now let's see the example of interrogative sentence. Had they been being friends since childhood? Simply we use the first helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, then we use the another helping verb after the subject. So had they been being friends since childhood? And at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. So please take a screenshot, so it will be easier for you to understand all the past simple, past continuous, past perfect, and the past perfect continuous tense. Now talk about the future tense. We have again the four tenses here in this slide: future simple, future continuous, future perfect, and the future perfect continuous. When first we talk about the affirmative or the positive sentence, we have the example, they will study mathematics, which means we are using subject at the start of a sentence, then the helping verb, then first form of the verb, and then object. That is the structure of future simple affirmative sentence. So we have the example, they will study mathematics. If you change the same sentence into the negative, so simply we have to use not after the helping verb. They will not study mathematics. This is an example of negative sentence of future simple tense. Now the interrogative example we have, will they study mathematics? As I already told you that if we want to change or if we want to make the interrogative sentence, simply we have to use the helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, then we have to use the form of verb according to the tense, which means in the future simple we are using the first form of the verb, then object, and at the end of a sentence the sign of interrogation. That is very compulsory. All right, this is all about the examples of future simple tense. Now let's see the example of future continuous tense. In the affirmative sentence, we have a structure subject, then will be. Again, we have a two helping verb here, will be loving. I mean in the first form of the verb with ing, then object. They will be loving you. Now, see the example of negative sentence. They will not be loving you. Simply we use not between will and be. They will not be loving you. And in the interrogative sentences, will they be loving you? It means we are using helping verb at the start of a sentence, then subject, and then be, another helping verb we can use after the subject, then ing form, and object. And after the object, we have to use the sign of interrogation. This is examples of future continuous tense. Now let's talk about the future perfect tense. In the future perfect tense, simply we use subject at the start of a sentence, then will have is a helping verb, and then third form of the verb. So we have example, by next week they will have earned lots of money. This is an example of affirmative sentence of future perfect tense. So we change the same sentence into the negative. So we have, by next week they will not have earned lots of money. It means simply we use not after the will and before the have. It means if we have a two helping verb, so we have to put not between the helping verbs. Is it clear, dear students? Now let's see the example of interrogative sentences. In the interrogative sentence, simply we use the helping verb at the start of a sentence, then the subject, then another helping verb we use after the subject, and at the end of a sentence, we use the sign of interrogation. So by next week, will they have earned lots of money? Is it clear? This is an example of future perfect tense. Now let's see the examples of future perfect continuous tense. Here we have a helping verb will have been, we can use after the subject, then the ing form, and then object. So we have the example, I will have been shopping on Tuesday. So this is example of future perfect continuous affirmative sentence. And the same sentence we change into the negative, so we have to put the not after the subject. I will not have been shopping on Tuesday. In the interrogative sentence, single helping verb we can use before the subject, and the another helping verb we can use after the subject. So will I have been shopping on Tuesday? And at the end of a sentence, we have to use the sign of interrogation. So this is all about the examples of affirmative, negative, and interrogative sentences of future simple, future continuous, future perfect, and the future perfect continuous tense. Please take a screenshot. And hopefully you got all the tenses or the review of the tenses of present, past, and the future tenses. All right. Now let's see the tenses and their identification. For example, the topic is translations. So you have to continue about the last words that as the identification words in Urdu. I mean, if the sentence of present indefinite tense is in Urdu, so how can you recognize that that is a tense of present indefinite tense? Through these words, I mean, if the sentence having these words in the ending sentence or in the ending words, so you can recognize that that is a tense of present indefinite tense. Ta hai, di hai, te hai. If the sentence have last word, ya tha, ya thi, ye thi, so that is the identification of past indefinite tense. If the sentence is in Urdu in the future indefinite tense, so the ending words of the sentence is ga, gi, ge. This is the identification of future indefinite tense. Now, let's talk about the present continuous tense. If the sentence is in the present continuous tense, I'm talking about if the sentence is in Urdu. All right, so the identification we have raha hai, rahi hai, rahe hai, clear, and past continuous tense, the ending words we have raha tha, rahi thi, rahe the. In the future continuous tense, if the sentence is in Urdu, so the last word we have or we can recognize through these words that is a tense of future continuous, raha hoga, rahi hogi, rahe honge. All right, this is all about the identification of present continuous, past continuous, and the future continuous tense. Hopefully you got it. Now let's talk about the perfect tense. First, we take the review of present perfect tense. In the present perfect tense, if the sentence is in Urdu, so we have a last word, chuka hai, chuki hai, chuke hai. In the past perfect tense, we have chuka tha, chuki thi, chuke the. In the future perfect tense, we have the last words chuka hoga, chuki hogi, chuke honge. While in the present perfect continuous tense, again we have raha hai, rahi hai, rahe hai. In the past perfect continuous tense, raha tha, rahi thi, rahe the. Well, the last we have future perfect tense, so the last ending words, if the sentence is in Urdu, we have raha hoga, rahi hogi, rahe honge. This is all about the identification of all the tenses. If the sentence is in Urdu, so we have the identification like that. Please take a screenshot. It will be easier for you to translate the sentences from English to Urdu. Now let's talk about the modal verb. We have the five types of modal verb. Ability, that is the first type, and we have a two modal verb, can or could. Let's see the example. Tavit can speak three languages. That is example number one. And example number two, we have he could speak French when he was five. These are the examples of type number one, ability of modal verb we have, can or could. Let's see the type number two, that is the permission. We have three modal verb, can, could, may. Again, we have three examples. The first example we have, can I sit in that chair, please? The second example, could I open the window? The third example we have, may I borrow your dictionary? This is the examples of can, could, may. I mean, the type number two is permission. Now, talk about the type number three, advice. We have a modal verb, should. So we have example, you should visit your dentist at least twice a year. That is the first example. The second example we have, you should try to lose weight. Is it there? Now let's see the fourth type of modal verb, and the modal verb we have must and have to. Let's see the example. I must memorize all of these rules about tenses. This is the first example. The second example we have, you have to take off your shoes before you get into the mosque. So this is the example that you guys do have to. Is it there? Now let's talk about the type number 5, possibility. And the help module what we have, might, may, could, can. So very first example we have, it looks nice, but it might be very expensive. There's a first example we have. And the second example we have, Richard may be coming to see us tomorrow. Please take a screenshot. This is all about the types of modal verb and examples. Now this is the time for translation. So in the language practice, unit 7.3, it is present in your book on page number 168. The translation from one language to another requires special skills. One cannot translate word for word, as word take different meanings in different contexts, even in the same language. Look at the following examples and translate them into Urdu or Sindhi. The sentence we have, I will go tomorrow in spring. There is a spring of hot water at Mangupuri in Karachi. The third sentence we have, since the spring is broken, this clock is not working. The fourth sentence we have, with the spring, the runner crossed the winning line. Is it clear? Now, let's see the exercise number 1 that is present in your book on page number 168. Translate the following sentences into Urdu or Sindhi. Write the translated sentences in your notebook. After completing, share your work with your partner. Make any changes needed and rewrite the sentences. So the first sentence we have, the train left the station at 7 o'clock. And the translation we have, Rail gaadi 7 baje station se ravana hui thi. The second sentence we have, I can train you to become a good cricketer. The translation is, main aapko ek achha cricketer banne ki tarbiyat de sakta hoon. The third sentence we have, there is plenty of light in this room. The translation we have, is kamre mein bahut sari roshni hai. The fourth sentence we have, please light all the candles on the cake. The translation is, barai meherbani cake par sari mombattiyan roshan kar de. Please take a screenshot so it will be easier for you to complete the work. Now, this is the sentence, these are the remaining sentence of the exercise 1. Sentence number 5, Jamal offered to book our seats on the bus. The translation is, Jamal ne bus par nishiste makhsus karne ki peshkash ki. Sentence number 6, have you seen my new book? The translation is, kya aapne meri nayi kitab dekhi hai? Sentence number 7, the principal asked the student to state the reason for being late. And the translation is, Sarbarai madarsa ne shagirdon se der se aane ki wajah bayan karne ko kaha. Sentence number 8, the state should ensure that all people follow the rules. The translation, ilaqe ki hukumat ko yaqeen hona chahiye ki sare log usoolon par amal karte hain. Sentence number 9, this is exactly my point that we should leave early. The translation is, mera nuktae nazar asal mein ye hai ki hame jaldi ravana ho jana chahiye. Please take a screenshot. This is all the translation of the remaining sentences of exercise number 1. Clear? Now, see this sentence number 10. This is all the remaining sentences of exercise number 1. Don't point at people when you are speaking about them. The translation is, logon ki taraf ishara mat karo jab aap inke bare mein baat kar rahe ho. Sentence number 11, my brother got the first rank in his final test. The translation is, mere bhai ne apne salana imtihan mein awwal darja hasil kiya. Sentence number 12, the rank of a soldier depends on many factors. The translation is, ek sipahi ka darja bahut se anasir par munassir hota hai. Please take a screenshot. It is the translation of exercise number 1. Let's see the exercise number 2 that is present on your book on page number 169. Work in pairs and translate the following sentences into Urdu or Sindhi such that you bring out their real meaning. Sentence number 1. The sun peeked happily from behind the clouds. The translation is, Suraj badalon ke piche se pura nikal aaya. Sentence number 2, the trees danced back and forth in the wind. Darakht hawa mein aage piche jhume. Sentence number 3. It was time to go home, but the bell refused to ring. The translation is, ye ghar jaane ka waqt hai, lekin ghanti ne bajne se inkaar kar diya. Sentence number 4. The angry sky roared and threw lightning around. Badal zor se garje aur ird-gird bijli chamki. Sentence number 5. The delicious smell of pudding pulled me to the kitchen. Pudding ki laziz khushbu mujhe bawarchi khane mein khench layi. Please take a screenshot. This is the translation of exercise number 2 present in your book on page number 169. The remaining sentence of exercise number 2. I can see that news travels quickly. Translation is, main dekh sakta hoon ki khabar foran phailti hai. Sentence number 7. I wish you were not always such a chicken. This is the proverb and the translation is, meri khwahish hai ki tum buzdil na hote. Please take a screenshot. This is the remaining translation of exercise number 2. Let's see the exercise number 3. That is present on your book on page number 169. Translate into Urdu. At some distance from this capital, there was a jungle. The king had heard that in the jungle there lived an old wise man who was considered a saint. He lived all alone. His fame had spread far and wide as someone who would solve everyone's problem. The king decided to consult the wise old saint, but the problem was he only mixed with the poor and needy. He did not mix with the rich and wealthy. Since the saint did not like meeting wealthy people, the king started thinking as how to approach him. This is the paragraph that you have to translate into the Urdu that is present in your book on page number 169. And the translation is, Darul Hukumat se kuch faasle par ek jungle tha. Basha sun chuka tha ke jungle mein ek akalmand buzurg rehta tha, jo ke sufi jana chahta tha. Wo bilkul akela rehta tha. Iski shohrat dur dur tak phail gayi thi ke wo har kisi ke masle ko hal kar deta tha. बादशाह ने इस अकलमंद बुजुर्ग सूफी से मशवरा करने का फैसला कर लिया लेकिन मसला ये था कि वो सिर्फ गरीबों और जरूरतमंदों से मिलता था वो अमीर लोगों से नहीं मिलता था क्योंकि सूफी अमीर लोगों से मिलना पसंद नहीं करता था तो बादशाह ने सोचना शुरू कर दिया कि इस तक कैसे पहुंचा जाए दिस इज द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज नंबर 3 दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन योर बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 169 प्लीज टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट Now, this is your home task. What you have to do, translate the following para into Urdu. Simply, you have to write the para in your copy at the grammar portion and you have to translate it into Urdu. The paragraph is, a long time ago, there lived a king who was in search of the secret of success. He thought if he could find out the answers to 3 questions, he would discover the secret and never fail. He thought and thought for many days, but the answer evaded him. So he called all his ministers and asked them these 3 questions. So this is the paragraph that you have to write in your copies, spare copies at the grammar portion, and you have to translate it into Urdu. All right. So wish you best of luck for your next class. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.